Hey guys, it's Zong, and today we are going to be making cheese boards, basic versus bougie. Today's video is in partnership with Kroger, where you can find ingredients fresher than fresh. All right, let's go ahead and get started with our basic board. All right guys, so I'm gonna start by walking you through the cheeses for a basic board. Luckily, I found this party tray cracker cut cheese at Kroger. There's like four different types of cheeses in here, so it makes it easy. But the rule of thumb for a cheese board, at least to me anyways, is that you have hard cheese and a soft cheese. So I opted for a brie. So we're gonna lay our cheeses out first. This one is cheddar, Swiss, Colby Jack, and pepper jack. I'm just gonna grab a few of each and just lay them out. That way they're easier to grab. Now for the brie, I'm gonna set it right in this corner over here. And now for our meat, I have peppered salami here, and I'm just gonna try to add it around like a ribbon. Just have one piece and fold it over, anchor it against the cheese. That way each piece is easy to grab. I'm gonna curve it a little bit so it's anchored by something else, the other cheese. So now for our fresh, fruity component, I'm gonna add some black seedless grapes and some apple slices. For the grapes, they look so yummy in a big clump like this, but I like breaking them down into smaller clumps so that people can grab them easily. All of the ingredients you can find at Kroger this fall season include the freshest selection of produce, pantry staples, baking goods, and everything in between. Okay, so the tray as it is right now covers all of the basics, but we can add a few more things just to liven it up a little bit. I'm gonna add a spread just because it goes really well with the brie. You can definitely add honey to this as a spread, but I found this honey fig butter, which sounded so yummy, and it would go so well with everything else too, that we're gonna go with it. Now we're gonna add our crunchy component. I like to add some salted mixed nuts. They just go so well with the cheese and the grapes. It feels like it's missing if I don't have nuts on my cheese board. These are roasted deluxe mixed nuts, so there's a little bit of everything in here. And finally, you cannot have a cheese board without some crackers. For a basic board, I always recommend getting like entertainment crackers. They're like round, they go with everything. This kind is a sesame variety, but I've seen whole wheat, multigrain, whatever you tend to prefer. And for the crackers, I've left some room at the edge right here, so we'll just lay it down. In these final stages, you can always move things around, zhuzh it up. And that's all there is to our very basic cheese board. I think this looks great for a small get together with your friends. Like for 3 to 4 people, this would be the perfect amount as like a starter or happy hour or whatever you're hosting this fall. All right, now let's move on to our bougie cheese board. The difference between the basic versus bougie board is that there's just more stuff you can add. There's more varieties of everything from cheeses to produce to pantry staples. Basically anything goes here. I'm gonna start with the cheeses again. Rule of thumb, for a bigger bougie board, I like to add anywhere from 3 to 5 different cheeses. Today, I'm gonna be doing another herbed brie. And then I always like to have cheddar on my board. I feel like cheddar is a universal cheese where everybody just enjoys, but not just any cheddar. I found this grape-soaked cheddar that the cheesemonger at Ralph's really recommended. He said this is their most popular one. It's actually by Murray's, which he told me is their new cheese area that Kroger just bought. So look out for one of those cheese stands in your Kroger or Ralph's. So this is a wine-soaked cheese Merlot. And then I also got a Gouda, which is a lot more nutty, very cheesy. Everybody likes Gouda. And of course, so I have 2 hard cheeses, a soft cheese, and I'd like to add another soft cheese just to balance it out. I have goat cheese here. It's sometimes a hit or miss with people. So this is how I'm gonna lay it out. I'm gonna cut one of the hard cheese and unwrap them. For the Gouda, since it's hard and people tend to just like to get little bits of it, I'm gonna break it up for them just halfway. And it looks very rustic and scraggly. And then for our wine-soaked cheddar, I already cut them into slices and I wanna show off the beautiful rind. So we're gonna fan it out. And it's okay if some of the pieces are broken too. So now because the board is gonna be filled completely, I kind of want to get my bearings down with the spread or the dip or whatever you want to add in here. Today, I'm gonna be adding a combination of that honey fig butter I showed you, some mustard, and some crunchy bread and butter chips. Pickles. In terms of placement on where I'm putting these dips, I'm just putting them where I think they would complement the cheese. So for example, stone ground mustard really goes well with cheddar, and then this fig honey jam, you can also use whatever jam you want, goes well with the nuttiness of the Gouda. And then these pickles, well, they go well with everything. Now we lay down our charcuterie. Today I'm gonna be using the rest of that peppered salami. I also found this old world spicy sopressata that's already cracker cut in Kroger's or Ralph's Deli. This one is by Private Selection. And then of course, I love prosciutto because it goes well with all of the fall produce that I bought. And I'm gonna show you where I place those later. But let's put our charcuteries down. For the peppered salami, I'm gonna line it up right here next to the brie because the brie is an herb one and I think they would complement each other. The sopressata, they're already cut. So I can put a nice little mound right here and then I'll have fun with the folding of the prosciutto. Prosciutto is really easy because it just kind of clumps together like this and it just looks so beautiful when placed down. Okay, we have our meats, we have our cheese, our spreads. Now we move on to our fresh produce. So because I wanted to take a really fall theme with it, use all the freshest seasonal ingredients, I'm gonna add some pear slices, grapes, stone fruit, I'm gonna use this plum, and of course some berries. Kroger really cares about where fresh ingredients come from. They have a true commitment to bringing fresh produce and ingredients front and center. Now I'm sure you guys noticed there's still a big gap right here. I added all the fruits to, well, I try to add it around the board, but I left this side blank on purpose because I wanted to add some fresh vegetables because I think it'll go well with the herbed brie. The veggie corner. So whenever I'm doing a big board like this, I usually don't like to take up too much space with crackers, so we're gonna serve the crackers on the side. But what I will add to this board are some treats. So I have nuts because, like I said, I think all cheese boards should have nuts. I also have some sweet and dried cranberries, which will add another fruity factor, but it has a different texture. And of course, some treats. We have dark chocolate covered almonds. And because things look a little bit bare right here, I don't want to put all the nuts just right here. I'm gonna move a few things around. And we'll round it out with some more plums right over here. So the board is beautiful as it's presented here. My favorite parts are these little fruits and vegetables sticking out. It just adds another dimension to the board. But since this is a bougie board, I always love to add a floral flair to it, in which I got some flowers from their floral department. These just scream fall. We have these mum balls, we have some chamomile and chrysanthemum, and I'm just gonna add them to the board where I think it needs like a pop of color. And here's our completed bougie cheese board with the crackers on the side. I just love all of the pops of colors from the floral. It just has that very fall cozy vibe here. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Don't forget to check out your local Kroger for the freshest produce and ingredients available, pantry staples, and everything else in between. Don't forget to hit that like and subscribe button and comment below and let me know which board you enjoyed most and which are the components that you would try on your next cheese board, because you guys have to try it. Thanks for watching. I'll see you guys next time. Bye.